As the Air Force looks to evolve ahead of its adversaries, one of the goals it's looking at is improving pilots' abilities to work with so-called drone wingmen, autonomous aircraft that can carry out everything from airstrikes and intelligence gathering to electronic warfare. To get an update on where the Air Force stands with the development of that capability, Deputy Secretary of the Air Force Kristen Baldwin spoke with Defense News reporter Stephen Losey. Have a look.
I'd like to dive in deeper on the issue of tech transition. Secretary Kendall and other officials in the Air Force have put some pretty ambitious goals on the table for technology they'd like to develop. Most notably, the program that's getting a lot of headlines is the concept of collaborative combat aircraft, so-called drone wingmen that could fly alongside the F-35, the Next Generation Air Dominance platform, to carry out everything from strike missions to ISR to electronic warfare to even being decoys. Australia has been working on something similar with their Loyal Wingman program. Can you talk a little bit about how your office would like to is working on trying to pave the way for collaborative combat aircraft to become a reality, and how you're helping with that?
We are. Of course, it's an operational imperative. One of the examples that we did for collaborative combat aircraft is we started out, we leveraged technology that was maturing in our S&T program that was bringing to bear autonomous capabilities, autonomous aircraft capabilities. Also,
You're referring to Skyborg?
Yes, I was going to talk about our Skyborg Vanguard. Thank you. So we initiated a program called Skyborg. We called it a Vanguard because it's a premier S&T program that has that is linked with not just an S&T program, but it's linked with prototyping and experimentation resources as well. And it has a operational user identified and a program executive office identified. So with those key elements, we have an opportunity for streamlined tech transition. And so that's what kind of makes it a Vanguard program. This program demonstrated autonomous collaborative software that could be applied not only on the main system, the manned aircraft, but on unmanned platforms that may be bringing to bear different types of missions, whether it be sensing or weapons or electronic attack or training. And so that's what the Skyborg Vanguard did, was help evaluate and demonstrate, okay, can that technology work for us? How would it work? And concept of operation and TTPs really informing the trades? That whole effort then transitioned to the collaborative combat aircraft program, Loyal Wingman, that is now maturing and being led by our program executive office. So it's a really great example of how we're trying to bring to bear rapid capabilities in support of the Secretary's priorities.